Parinita, why don't you unmute yourself?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So we were discussing yesterday how do we try to find out what is the gain of an amplifier with active load. So either the load can be a PMOS transistor or NMOS transistor. So let us have a look at amplifiers in a general view. So let me just assume that this is an amplifier. Okay. Second. Assume that you have a power supply inbuilt. Does these two are the terminals which are coming out for the input, and these two are the terminals which are coming out for the output? Parinita?
Yes.
Assume that this is an amplifier. So amplifier is a black box. This is a black box. So I have two terminals for input. I have two terminals for output. So this is input. This is output. Fine. So this type of network, we call it as two-port network. Two-port network. So two ports are nothing but the port at the input side, I'll call it as input port. This is an output port. Fine. So this is an amplifier. This is an amplifier. Now, I have to represent this amplifier black box in a different way. That is, an amplifier can be represented by some input impedance, and there is a voltage source and a resistor R0. So this is R out. This is, I will say it as A0 into V in, and this is R in. Fine?
Yes, sir.
This is fine. Now the amplifier is now represented that black box. Now if you just go, just open that black box, it looks like this. Can you see there is input resistance at port, input port, and at the output port you have what is this here? You can see A0 into Vin. So instead of writing this as a voltage source, simple voltage source, shall I say this is voltage dependent voltage source, because this voltage source depends on Vin. This is a voltage source having magnitude A0 into Vin. Can you see this voltage source depends on what is Vin here? So Vin is the input that is applied at the input port. So I can.
The video is paused.
Video is paused.
Oh yeah. So we can't see anything.
Oh, what happened? Same issue as we had last time. I don't know. What I'll do is I'll stop share it and then again share this. How about now? Is it better? Is it visible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I will write it more clearly, meaning instead of writing this as simple voltage source, I will write it as something like this. So this is a representation how you do it for a voltage dependent voltage source, no? Am I correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Of course, both are same. Here, I'm just simply representing this by the symbol which is represented for a voltage dependent. It's a dependent source. So what is the dependence here? This voltage source certainly depends on what is the input voltage that is applied. And of course, there is an A0. This A0 is called as intrinsic gain. Getting? What is this A0 now? A0 is intrinsic gain. So that's what we discussed in the last class. So I will write it as R in. This is R out. This is what? input port. This is A0 into Vin. So this is your, let me say this is Vin. So now A0 is represented as intrinsic gain. So what do you mean by this intrinsic gain? Intrinsic gain of an amplifier is that gain with open circuited output, open circuited load. Assume that this is the load now. This is the load. I'll call it as RL because L stands for load now. Suppose if I open circuit this, so shall I write the equivalent circuit of this? How does the equivalent circuit of this looks like? Does, of course, assume that there is a lambda which is non-zero. Will you end up with that R0 also? Correct? One second.
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಅವರೇನು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅವರು ಅಂತ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ದಲ್ಲೇ ಇರೋರು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್. ಇವರೆಲ್ಲ ಬಹಳ ಹಳಬ್ರು ಸರ್. ಇವರು ತೀರ ಹಳಬ್ರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಆಗಲೇ ಒಂದೊಂದು ವರ್ಷ ಎರಡು ವರ್ಷ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ತೆಗೆದ್ಬಿಡೋದ್ರು ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಇವರು ಹಳೆಯ ಹಳಬ್ರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಉಳಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರೀ ಎಂತ ಡಿಪ್ಲೊಮಾ ಹುಡುಗರೆಲ್ಲ ಬಿಟ್ಟೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿಟ್ಟೋಗಿದ್ರು ಸರ್. ಇಲ್ಲವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಬರೀ ಅಷ್ಟು ಮೇಲೆ ಬರೋದೇ ಸರ್. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು. ಅದೇ ಸರ್, ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾರಿಲ್ಲ.
ಸಾರಿ, ಶಾಲ್ ಐ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಇಂಟು ವಿ ಜಿ ಎಸ್? ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಜಿ ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಇನ್, this is V0. You can see now I have not connected RL, so is it now open circuited load? Sorry, Parinita, now can you see this is open circuited now?
Yes sir.
If I consider that, then I'll be writing this as RL or whatever RD. So since I'm considering it as open circuited, I will not write this. Then what is the gain of this amplifier? So gain of this amplifier, I will call it as A0, which is open circuited load gain or the intrinsic gain. Is it not equal to minus GM into R0? Any doubt here? Okay, why it is minus GM into R0? So now assume that this is R0. There is no load now. So what is V0 now? So what is V0? So shall I write V0 is equal to, of course, V0 is nothing but voltage drop from here to here. So is it not this voltage drop? Is it not I0 into what? R0? What is this I0? Is it not negative of this current? Is it not minus GM into VGS into R0? And is it not equal to minus GM into Vin into R0? And this is V0. Is V0 by Vin is equal to minus GM into R0. What is the condition here? RL is open circuited. Correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So, shall I now write it as this as A0? What is this A0? A0 is the intrinsic gain, which is now without this. With this as open circuit, if you connect that, I will call it as AV with some load. What is that load? RL is equal to RD. Correct? See now, I'll write what is AV now. AV is what? AV is again V0 by Vin, but you are considering RL as RD. Correct? So now, shall I consider RD here now? Hello.
Yes, sir.
If I consider RD, what will be V0? Is this V0 is I0 into R0 parallel RD into I0? Correct?
Yes, sir.
On the same line, suppose if you come down here, will this expression become minus GM into RD parallel R0? So this I'll call it as AV. What is the difference between AV and A naught? A naught is the intrinsic gain with load open circuited. What is AV? AV is the gain of the amplifier with some load. That load in this case is RD. Correct?
Okay.
This load can be a resistive load. It can be an active load. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. let me just, okay. Now, what we understood is, what is A naught? What is, can you just define what is A naught now?
The intrinsic.
Intrinsic gain. This is a gain parameter. Intrinsic gain of the amplifier with
open circuited
load. Load is open circuited. You find the gain. It is still V naught by V in, but the load is actually open circuited. Correct?
Yes, sir.
If you want to find this, lambda has to be non-zero. You cannot take lambda equal to 0. If you take lambda equal to 0, this is not there. Then you cannot find A naught at all. Correct?
Yes, sir.
While finding intrinsic gain, lambda has to be a non-zero value. It can be 0.1, 0.01, whatever the value is. You need to consider this E is always for lambda equal to non-zero. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now out of R in, R out and A naught, we got to know what is A naught is. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So, shall I now write what is A naught of this? A naught of this is what? Gm into R naught. Gm into R naught. Am I correct? Mm-hmm. Minus Gm into R naught. Now, what is R in now? R in is nothing but the input impedance of this black box if you see from here. If I see from here, what is the input impedance? This I call it as R in. If you have a black box, assume that is an amplifier. It has got two ports here. So if you look at this side, what is the impedance? If you look from this side, what is the impedance? Suppose if this is input, if you are looking from this side, what is the impedance? And if you are looking from this side, what is the impedance? It is called as input impedance. This is called as output impedance. So what do you mean by looking from this side? Because if you see it is in your eyes, you cannot make out because it is not visible there. It's not visible. So whenever I say R in, it is electrical impedance offered by this amplifier to the signal. So how do I find out? Assume that you have an amplifier. You have two ports. You open circuit the load. This is for finding what is Rin. This is how do you find Rin. You have an amplifier, open circuit the load. Correct? Load is open circuited. Here you put a dummy source. Dummy source by name by magnitude Vx. This is a dummy source. You know what is the magnitude of this. Let me call it as Vx. Let me find out what is Ix. Getting the point? I'm trying to apply a dummy source with magnitude. This is an AC source with magnitude Vx. I will want to find out what is the Ix. So you know that Vx by Ix has to be input impedance. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So if you take the ratio of Vx by Ix, then it happens to be the input impedance of this amplifier. Condition is that this should be open circuited. Correct? Shall we do the same thing for this here? For this amplifier, okay, let me call it as R1, R2, and this is RL. If I want to do it for this amplifier, what I should do first? First condition here. What is the first condition? I need to open circuit the load.
Same. Yes, sir.
Correct? So I'll do the same thing. First, I'll write the. Of course, this is whatever R in, R out you are finding, it is for a small signal model. So, first I should write the small signal model of this amplifier. Is it not the small signal model of this amplifier? With this as R1, R2. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So, I will write the small signal model of the amplifier. There is a R1, there is a R2, and this is Gm into VGS. I have R0, I have open circuited this. Can you see I'm not connecting anything here? Open
Yes,
circuited.
sir.
What is this? R1, R2. This is R0. This is still there. This is again I'm finding it for lambda equal to non-zero. So what I'll do, I will not connect the input source, I will collect a dummy source. Because what is the intention here? What is the intention? Intention is to find what is Rn. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will find out what is Ix is. Shall I rewrite this as something like this now? Vx. Shall I put it as R1 parallel R2? This is open circuit. And is this the circuit is? What is this? Gm into Vgs. This is R0. Am I correct? This is still, okay, whatever. Vgs, alright, whatever you write. This is V0. What is the intention now?
Find Rn.
Find Rn, that is Vx by Ix. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So, can I find out what is Ix in this loop? Okay, as in your networks. So this is a very simple network. So, is Ix is equal to Vx by R1 parallel R2?
Yes, sir.
So, what is actually Vx by Ix now? Is it not R1 parallel R2?
Yes.
This is Rn. Even though this circuit is there, since it is open circuited, of course, we're not considering this at all, because what I want is Vx by Ix, that I'm getting it in the input loop itself. Is that clear? Any doubt
yes,
here
sir.
For anyone? I am writing. So, okay. Is the input impedance of this amplifier? Is the input impedance of this amplifier, is it not R1 parallel R2? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Now, Rn is done. Rn is done. What is the procedure we followed? We took the amplifier. We took the amplifier, put a dummy source Vx, and open circuited the load, and trying to find what is the expression for Ix. So, Ix was given by Vx by R1 parallel R2. We got it as Ix is equal to so and so, from which I can get the ratio of Vx by Ix is nothing but R1 parallel R2. Similarly, I want to find what is R out. Correct? I want to find what is R out is. Again, what I'll do, I will open circuit the load. Shall I again write something like this now? Okay, now the procedure is, this is the amplifier. This is your, because you have to find the output resistance, I will put a dummy source here. Can you see I'm finding a dummy source here?
Yes, sir.
This is now Ix. The thing here is that, because there was one independent source by the name Vin, correct? Hello?
Yes,
there,
sir.
Of course, in this amplifier, there is an independent source by name Vin. I have to make all independent sources zero. That means I have to make Vin equal to zero. What do you mean by Vin equal to zero? I have to short it. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This is one of the conditions. Why you want to make this Vin equal to zero means there should not be influence of any external sources while finding the output resistance. Correct? Since I don't want to have the influence of any other sources, I will make the input voltage as zero. That is zero only when you short circuit that. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So now I will take the amplifier without the load. That is something like this. Is this your small signal model of the amplifier without the load? Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I will rewrite that. Sir. I will rewrite that. This is R1, R2. This is again Gm into VGS, this is R0. Can you see now I'm putting the dummy source?
Yes, sir.
See now I'm shorting this. This is what? R1, R2, this is VGS. Is that fine?
Yes.
Hello. Is it visible? Everything is fine, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now if you short this, what is this voltage? What is the voltage VGS? Suppose if it is short, okay, because both the potentials are same. What is the potential difference? 0 volt.
It will become reductant source, sir.
No, it will be 0, no?
Yes, sir.
The voltage is 0. We are talking about what is the voltage here.
Zero.
The voltage is 0. When the voltage is 0, how about this current source magnitude? Because you have GM into VGS. When VGS becomes 0, what is the magnitude of this current?
0.
0. How do you represent 0 current source in the symbol?
Open circuit.
Open circuit. So I will rewrite this as something like this now. Can see this is open circuit because this is short circuited. See now, R1, R2, this is gate, drain, source, this is open circuit. Then, can you find what is Ix? Is it
yes,
not
sir,
Vx by R0? Or
yes,
Vx by Ix, is it not R0?
Yes, sir.
This is Rout. The output resistance of this amplifier, the output resistance of this amplifier is R0. The input resistance is R1 parallel. Here we are writing, no? What is Rin, what is Rout, what is A0?
Yes, sir.
What is Rout now? R0. What is Rin? R1 parallel R2. What is A0? Minus GM into?
Minus GM into R0.
R0. Correct? These are the parameters for this amplifier. Now I can represent that amplifier by a input resistance with magnitude. Of course, let me not write a rhombus. I will write it like this. So of course, since I'm writing it as A0 into Vin, this is R out, this is R in, this is my output, this is the input. Correct? Plus minus. Suppose if I connect a load of RD, what is, now this is V0 now. What is V0 is equal to here for this loop? Is V0 is equal to A0 into V in multiplied by RD divided by R out plus RD? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
This is a simple loop equation. Applied voltage, or can I write it as, or you just write in your, can I write A0 into Vin is equal to, how do you write? Just write I into R out plus RD. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So, what is V0 now? Is V0 is equal to I into RD? Correct?
Yes, sir.
What is I? Can I write I is equal to A0 into Vin by R out plus RD? If this is my I from this expression multiplied by RD is my V0. Am I correct? Are
yes,
these two same? I want the response.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, how I could very easily able to write is, if you have a voltage source, if you are measuring this voltage across this RD, that voltage source into this resistance divided by the sum of the two resistances. That's what is the potential difference, sorry, potential divider rule. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Now, we know what is, can we find what is gain now? AV. It is V0 by Vin. V0 by V in is equal to A naught into RD by R out plus RD. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
What is actually A naught?
Minus
J into R naught into RD by R. What is R out? What is R out here?
Oh.
This is R naught, no? This R out is R naught.
Yes.
So is your final AV is coming something like this? Is that correct? Is it not equal to minus GM into R naught parallel RD?
Yes, sir.
Which you used to write it. Suppose if a resistor RD comes in parallel with this, so what is the gain? It is, that's what we wrote here. Where is that? Here. Can you see here? This is the gain of the amplifier. This you got it by putting RD here. You will get the same gain even if you do it using this type of analysis. Why we are introducing this analysis is, in many circuit, it may not be possible to write this type of small signal model. We go for this type of analysis. What did we do here? What is this actually? Can someone summarize, or let me summarize and I'll ask someone else to summarize. So we are representing the CS amplifier with RD load as a two port amplifier network. At the input port, I have the, okay, at port 1, I have the input, at port 2, I have the output. Now I want to find, of course, this has got some input resistance, and at the output port, I'm going to have a, what is that? Intrinsic gain multiplied by the input voltage, and I'm going to have a R out. So we want to find what is R in. How do you find R in? So for finding out R in, we will open circuit the load. So how did you do? We actually did this. Can you see here? We actually open circuited the load, applied Vx, found out what is Vx by Ix, that happens to be R in. How do you find R out? It is simple. You apply the input, sorry, a voltage, a dummy source of Vx at the output port, short the input. Why we want to short the input? Because there should not be any influence of the independent sources on my circuit. That's why I'll make that voltage as zero. So this is made zero. I'm applying this, and this is how the circuit looks like. So I'm trying to find out what is Vx by Ix. It is found out to be R naught for this circuit. For this circuit. So finally we obtained what is the expression for the gain with load. With load as RD, it is coming out to be minus GM into R naught parallel RD. Now, instead of a load of RD, so let us recap all these things now. Can somebody just summarize? Okay, what I did? What did I say now? Who is register number 25? Is 25 there? US in 25? Hello.
Hello.
US in 25. Hello. US in 35. Are you not there? 25, 35.
Sir.
Who is 20? Your is 35.
Sir.
Ah, tell me. You just summarize this. How did you find R in? How did you find R out? How did you find AV? How do you find R in?
R in, R1 is when...
How do you find R in? First thing is that you have to open circuit the load. All of you write it. For finding out R in, the procedure is... open circuit the load, connect a dummy source Vx, just find Vx by Ix. Just three steps. First step is, for R in, RL is made infinity, meaning open circuit. Then at input put a dummy source Vx, put a dummy source Vx and find what is Vx by Ix, of course, and then find Ix. Once you find Ix, you get the ratio of Vx by Ix, that happens to be Rin, correct? Similarly for Rout, what is the procedure on the same lines? Make V in equal to 0 and then put a Vx at the output port, find Ix, which will give you Vx by Ix, which is nothing but R out. Did you do the same thing? Hello? 35, 75, no one is there.
Yes, sir.
Okay, is this the thing what I did? Nothing more than this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how did we find AV? We actually connected the load to this two-port network. We connected the load RD. This we know R0. This is minus GM into R0 into V in. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
This is RD. Now you find what is V0. If you find V0, V0 by V in becomes the gain or AV. What is the difference between A0 and AV? What is A0?
Intrinsic gain.
What is AV?
Gain when the load is
gain.
Gain with load, gain without load. Without load. So how do you find gain with load? This is a circuit. You know what is the voltage source. What is the voltage? Now it is RD multiplied by the current. What is the current? It is minus GM into R0 into Vin overall plus the overall resistance. That is divided by the overall resistance. It is on. So of course this Vin, this is actually V0. So this will Vin will go off. So is it not GM into RD in parallel with R0? Correct? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let me write this circuit now. Okay, this is VB. Since it is DC voltage, shall I write it as R0 to am I correct? Because if it is something like this, you panic out how to write it. Because what is the effective resistance looking up here? We saw yesterday. Was it not R0? Where is that yesterday's discussion?
It's 1 by lambda dB.
Where is that yesterday's discussion? Yesterday's discussion was, I think we discussed that. Okay. Okay, we actually discussed with a source. I think all of you know that if you are looking towards the drain side, it is R0 resistance. Is that is known? Known or not known? Hello?
It's known, sir.
This is R0 too, no? Why it is 2 means because it is M2. This is R0?
Yes, sir.
Can you give me what is Rin? What is R out and what is A naught and what is AV for this circuit and what is of course RL. RL is now R naught too. What is Rin?
So, 1 by lambda.
What 1 by?
R naught can be found out as 1 by lambda ID, right?
नहीं, yeah, of course, how do you find, I'm not actually asking you to find the numeric value of R naught too, I'm asking you to find out what is the expression for R in, R out, A naught and AV. Now, what was the expression for R in here? What is the difference? See here, what is the difference between this circuit and this circuit? Let me just make both of them visible. Just a minute. What is the difference here? What is the difference? Same circuit, no?
Yes, sir.
Instead of RD, resistive load, you have an active load, which is in effect seen as R naught two.
Yes, sir.
Is it perfect? That is the only thing. This is a CS amplifier. This is also a CS amplifier. What is the role of this M1? What was the role of M1 here? To give the transconductance.
Yes, sir.
What was the role of this M1? Same role. But what is the role of this transistor M2? It is to act like a load. Since it has to act like a load, it has to have some resistance. That resistance is R naught. So, are these two 100% same?
Yes, sir.
Except here it is RD, here it is R naught.
RL.
R naught. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, then what is RIN? Is it not R1 parallel R2?
Yes, sir.
What is R out?
It's R1.
Is it not R naught 1?
Yes, sir.
What is A naught?
It's minus GM into R naught 1.
Is it not minus GM 1 into R naught 1?
Yes, sir.
You can see I am specifically writing GM1, R01 because those are all corresponding to that transistor, M1.
Yes, sir.
What is AV now? Is it minus, not minus GM1, R01 into
parallel
R02 divided by R01, R01, R02. Of course, this is parallel combination.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I replace this by this circuit, you can see now this is M1, this is M2, this is what? Again, bias voltage, this is CC, R1, okay, this is R1, R2, this is V0, this is VDD. Now, I will rewrite this as for the time being, because am I correct now?
Yes, sir.
Again, similarly, tell me what is RL, what is RN, what is Rout. What is A naught? What is A?
So RL is 1 by GM.
1 over GM2. We have to say specifically this is for second transistor. What is RIN?
Yes. 1 over GM2.
RIN. RIN.
1 over GM2 parallel of R.
Where is 1 over GM2 coming? This is simply coming in parallel with this one. This is on the other side. How does this will come onto the input side? If you write the equivalent circuit of this, if you write the equivalent circuit of this, is it not this?
Yes, sir.
This is 1 over GM2, this is R01, this is minus GM into VGS, and this is R1, this is R2. So this is input impedance. The input impedance is parallel combination of this, you know. How does this 1 over GM2 will come onto the input side?
No, sir.
This is coming onto the output side, no?
Yes, sir.
Then what is R out?
It's R naught 2.
Just R naught 1. This transistor, as we wrote it here. What is the difference between this and this, I say? Only it's this.
Blank.
Am I correct?
Sir, it's not. It's lagging too much, sir.
Okay. Lagging. Let me stop it. And again share. Okay, is it fine now?
It's not visible. Sure.
Okay. So this A naught is again minus GM1 into R naught 1. AB is minus GM1 R naught 1 1 over GM2 divided by R naught 1 plus 1 plus 1 over GM2. This is again the PAL combination. Okay.
R naught 1 corresponds to NMOS 1, right?
Sir? Yeah. That's what is R out 1. That's what is R out.
Yeah, sir. When we are taking R in, R out, we should not consider the second MOS rod. What?
Because second MOSFET is open circuit then. Because how do you find your R out? While finding out R out, can you see your port is open circuited here? Where is that? Can you see you don't have any port there? You're not having port. There is no RD here. Okay, let me also here while finding out Vin is made 0 at the output you have Vx. There is no RD, there is no load at all.
Yes, sir.
You're not connecting M2 at all. I'll not be connecting M2. So are you connecting M2 here?
No, sir. We are only connecting the Vx.
When I say R out, the R out of this one. When I say R out, it is this R out.
Okay,
this
R out. Got it.
This is your RL. This is A naught into Vin. This is Rin. I'm talking about this R out. In this R out, the load is not there.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yeah,
okay. We will see in the next class a few more circuits. So that, of course, you just see, go through this video and of course go through the videos that I've already uploaded. That is the old videos where we discussed many such circuits. So you'll get an idea. Okay, then thank you.